Hey, I got a question about how you could outline each box separately so the viewer will grab the attention one by one. In the end, you want to achieve such a result. With my mouse click, I make the first animation, and with another mouse click, I switch to another box. Mouse click, mouse click. So going forward in the presentation, you always take into consideration another box. For that reason, I'll take those four steps, I'll maybe create a new slide and show you how you eventually could do this. This will be a very simple animation, so really don't worry about it. At first, obviously, we would need to select a rectangle to make the line around this box. Okay, I'll go to Insert, I'll click on Shapes, and I'll select the simple rectangle shape. I'll place the shape around here, of course, and I'll try to make a line out of it. In order to make this a line, you just need to remove the shape fill and add the outline fill. We have shape outline here. Okay, shape fill, no fill. Shape outline, select the desired color. Let's go for this orange, it looks pretty okay. And you have here more options. You can change the weight, for example, to 3 points. I'll make it a bit smaller. And now, when it comes to the trick, we only need to go to animations and select the proper animation. Now, if you are working the first time in PowerPoint and you don't know those animations well, you can go to animations, you can click here, and you can select more entrance effects, because we are aiming to get entrance effects. And you can simply click around and see what happens. For this very shape, not every animation will look perfect. The strips look really cool, also wedge should look very cool. So we have something like that. Why not use that? I'll press OK. And before I duplicate it, I wanted to have another animation on it. Let me open the animation pane and see what happens. As I click my mouse, this first animation happens. I'll press Ctrl+C, Ctrl+V. As I click my mouse the second time, the second one will appear. So I'll press Shift F5, the first click and the second click. The second click is okay, but in this moment, I would like this one to disappear and this one to appear. This would be very simple because as you can see, we need two instances of animation. So we need to add an exit animation here in order for this to fade out. While having this first box selected, you can see the first animation has highlighted. You only need to click on Add Animation, because if I click here, it will just change the animation. But if I click Add Animation, it will add another animation onto the same object. Now this time we want an exit animation, and we could use the same one, select more exit effects. We could again select Wedge, okay, and I can see I have three animations now. But this can't be like that. This one needs to go up, and needs to go with previous. Or no, sorry. It needs to go down and go together with the second one. This way, I have animation number one, and now two animations happen simultaneously. Now, for my taste, it's a bit too slow because this red one is a bit too long, but I can adjust that by making the duration less, clicking on the other one and delaying it a little bit. You can see now this will be better, and we would just need to repeat the steps. If I have a setup like that, maybe it would look better if I would have it like this, on mouse click, and this one with previous. Now just follow me along here. The first animation happens, then the second animation fades this one out, go to animations, and the last one will fade this one in. I'll delay it a little bit. I'll press Shift F5 and look, the first mouse click will make this one appear, and the second mouse click will make it like that. You have the box highlighted, your focus is entirely on the box, and the viewer knows exactly what you are explaining. And here we would just need to copy them over and make sure that everything is right. So here I would again select an exit animation for this one. I would need to click Add Animation. I won't go into detail, I will just add exit animation. this one as the last one, and delay it a little bit. This would be simple. Ctrl C, Ctrl V, click on this one, add animation. It can be a fade, no problem. I'll press the fade above it, and this one is already delayed a little bit. So you can go exactly through here what's happening, and if you don't know the animations, you can select play from to preview what's happening. PowerPoint tries to show us what's happening in this animation. Okay, Shift F5, the first click, the second click, third, fourth, and we can go over each box separately. A really nice animation. I won't call it a trick because it's just common practice. If you want to achieve an effect like that, you would go about this by animations one by one, fade in and fade out together. This is my tip for this lesson, a tutorial that was requested from a user, and I hope this will help you a lot and help everyone. So see you in other tutorials like this.